You're listening to Your Purpose and Business Podcast, where we connect you to possibilities. I'm your host, Raquel Walters, a two-time best-selling author, millennial speaker, corporate trainer, advocate, and clinical social worker at heart. Your Purpose and Business Podcast will connect you with everyday successful people who will share their impactful stories, insights, challenges, failures, and triumphs on how they're navigating the working world, whether by climbing the 9-to-5 corporate ladder or starting, growing, and scaling their business. So grab your pen and notebook because you'll want to implement the nuggets and tools, strategies shared in every episode. Class is in session. Hi, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Your Purpose and Business Podcast. My name is Raquel Walters, and I'm so honored to have a guest on today, my very dear friend, Tatiana Atija. And Tatiana, welcome to the show.
Hi, Raquel. How are you doing?
I'm great. So before I introduce people to you, Tatiana, tell me something about yourself, but just to throw it out there that you would like people to know before I read into your bio.
Okay, well, I'm a very bubbly and social person.
Yes.
But most importantly, I'm a very great motivator. So I just want everyone to know that's the main thing I stand for in life. I can speak life into anyone I meet, any idea they have. I'm a great motivator.
That's awesome to know. And I'm sure the audience will be hearing that throughout our interview. Yeah. So I'm really so excited. So Tatiana Atija is the owner and buyer for Atija Styles, which is an online women's clothing store. And yeah. So Tatiana, like, tell us a little bit about how did your clothing store came into fruition?
Well, first, to give you the backstory, I think I started Atija Styles because I had a previous business venture that I did. I used to sell online handmade jewelry on Etsy. I'm not sure if everyone knows Etsy, but it's the main marketplace for people who make their own, you know, products. So I started on Etsy and I did really good. I did really good. I did like 10,000 in sales just being home, making like normal products that I didn't think anyone would like. But once I went out there and posted it, they were buying my stuff. Unfortunately, I didn't test the market and did my research to know that, okay, during the Christmas time, which we're in right now, business gets slow because a lot of people, they're like focused on Black Friday and sales and sales and sales, so they won't be trying to buy from any new vendors. I had left my job at the time, you know, thinking that, okay, I'm over my job, so now it's time to focus on my business. So I leaped headfirst in that, but even though I wouldn't say fail, I'm not going to use the word fail, okay? It just wasn't the right time for me, and it was a lesson for me. Mm-hmm. So because I learned from that, it basically gave me the will to know that, okay, I can have a product, I can really push towards getting people to buy my product, so why not go after what I really want to do?
Mm-hmm.
For years, I've had friends tell me that, you know, I should go into the fashion, I should do something with clothing. Like, a lot of people don't know, but I can design, I can draw my stuff, I can, like, I'm a ripper, like, I do ripping on jeans, I can take a normal outfit and add something new to it and flip it and make it, like, a great style. So, I had a lot of stuff happen to me this year, and that just basically changed my whole perception on life that, you know, God basically took me out of a very bad accident, you know, and I was telling myself, it's time for me to really just stop wasting time and really go after what I want. And what I really want is to use my God-given talent, you know, which is being a creator, and just put it out there in the world. And it just came up with Atija Styles. Important thing is that it took me a while to get the name of the company. And it's weird how I came up with it because my name is Tatiana, my first name. My middle name is Jade. So I'm like, okay, Tati, Jade, let me just drop the A to T off the Tati, Ati, and J-A, and that's how I came up with Atija.
Oh,
and
it
flowed, and then I realized it's an actual word, actual name, and I'm like, let me put style on it, and there you go, Atija Styles.
Wow, that's very impressive, and you said a lot there, so let me, like, scale it back a little bit
yeah.
and dissect it, if you may.
So you said that you had a business before, it was doing well on Etsy, but then you felt that you weren't prepared as far as market research and testing the market. Well, obviously you tested the market because you had an audience because you were getting sales. However, prior to that, like, what led you into going into entrepreneurship? Was that significant?
I feel like I was meant to be an entrepreneur, honestly. I feel like from I was little, like, my mom, I used to tell my mom from day one, let me go work, let me go do this. I want to be a dancer. When I was in school, I used to bring candy to school to sell. Yeah. I used to take to school to sell. So I feel like deep down, I always have that hustler mentality. I always wanted to do something for myself. So it kind of stuck with me. Throughout the years, I did little stuff of entrepreneurship. It's just that I didn't take it seriously. I did a potluck for my job one time. I cooked for them, and they begged me to make food to sell at my job. So yeah. I was working and cooking food and selling. So it's like it's been a part of me for a while. It's just that I think I didn't have the necessary information to really, like, make it work. And it was, like, me winging it all those years. But now I actually did it the right way because I'm actually really serious about it this time.
Mm-hmm. And I love your story because it sounded as if, like, you tested out different things because it sounds like you're multi-passionate. You're great. You have skills at different things. You said cooking. You said, you know, there's so many other things. For somebody who's working a full-time job right now but wanting to transition into starting their own business but not really sure of, okay, what skills I have that I can put some effort and energy behind in order to turn it into something that I can offer to people. Like, what was that moment, if you had one, or was it that you tried different things and then you said, okay, I'm going to go after fashion? Is the question clear?
That's it. Like, along with, you have people who have different skills, but I feel like creative people, we go through a lot because we have so many things that we're good at, and it's really difficult for us to choose one. And that's been my problem over the years. So I feel like whatever it is that comes the easiest to you, I don't know if anyone listens to Steve Harvey, but that's what he says, you know, the thing that comes the least or takes the least amount of effort, the thing that you love, that's your passion and that should be your business. Mm-hmm. And I just had to really, like, look into myself and tell myself, like, what do I like? I used to be a manager at a shoe store and a clothing store, and I used to dress all the mannequins, and the girls used to come in and buy all my outfits off the mannequins to style them. So it's like I have all this years and years of retail and customer service. So no matter what it is, the making the jewelry along with the clothing, it can all be one. So it doesn't really matter. I'm still really in the same niche that I really want to be in. So that's why I decided to go into fashion, because it can allow me to create my own clothing and still have a love and passion for something I'm doing. Mm-hmm. Now, when it comes to the 9-to-5, it took me a long time to really get a job that allowed me to really do everything I want to do and still earn a living, because we need money. Most of us, we need money. We don't have someone backing, you know, our company. So it is really hard. But honestly, if you want it, you will make the time for it.
Right. I mean, I love that, those answers. And just to go back a little bit, because you mentioned about Steve Harvey and the saying, him saying that, you know, whatever it is that you do that, I guess, takes the least amount of effort, or you can do effortlessly, not that you're not going to do nothing, but effort, it comes easier to you. That's typically your passion or your purpose in life. Yeah. So which leads me to say to you, Tatiana, what do you think is your purpose? Because it's a big question and it's often hard to define. But for you, what do you think is your purpose in the world at this point in your life?
At this point in my life, and I really love that question because that's the journey I'm on right now, the thing I do that takes the least amount of effort, I'm doing it right now. I'm talking. I'm a people person. I'm a social butterfly. I don't get all scared. Like, I'm just open to talk to anyone. So eventually the long-term goal is I want to go into public speaking, motivational speaking. Mm-hmm. However, I just believe for me to motivate, like, another woman or someone else, I need to work on myself and my success story first. So I can say, this is what I did. These are the strategies that I implemented. And this is how I got the result. Mm-hmm. So, hey, maybe you want to just take a step from me. I don't think it's right to preach to the masses and not have any work to show for it. So my purpose is to be a speaker.
But I can honestly say that I disagree. Really? And I'll tell you why. Because
why?
Think of it that everyone is on a different journey.
Yeah.
So even though you think that you need to achieve a certain thing or be at a certain space in order for you to motivate, you never know your struggles, your failures that's happening currently, how it will impact another person's life. I would say to motivate, start motivating now. You're motivating every single day, different capacities. And so, as you grow, your story will get bigger. But for right now, your story is still good enough to share with the world.
I motivate, like, trust me. Like, I have a friend, we live in the same house, and we both decided, you know, we're going to start our businesses, we're going to make a leap. And, you know, I was, you know, pushing her for that. Whatever I had to do, I did it so she can get started. If you're around me, there's no way you're going to want to do something, and I'm not going to want to push you. Yeah. So I know, that's how I know that's my purpose, because I'm doing everything on a smaller scale. Long-term goal, I do want to take it to a larger scale where I'm speaking to the masses, where I can say I can take a trip to Jamaica and say, okay, let me host a workshop and try to help the younger generation. But I really do believe that if I'm going to listen to someone, I'm going to listen to the Elon Musk, I'm going to listen to Steve Harvey, I'm going to listen to Grant Cardone, although Tony Robinson. Those are the people I'm going to listen to and who I'm listening to right now. Mm-hmm. And that's why I have this drive, because they have proven that it can be done. So I feel like you can speak more to people if you have, like, you know, you have something to show. Something to show. It's like, if you're going to talk about Gandhi had to do stuff. Gandhi had to go through his struggles for me to be able to say Gandhi's a great teacher, Oprah, all those people. So I feel like it's good for me to have a good backstory to show that, hey, this is what I did, because I feel like there's so many people, you know, out here motivating. It's a big world for motivators. I just want to know that while I'm motivating, I can say, this is what I did here. I think you should try it, and I think it's going to work for you. I know that I'm sending them out in the world, you know, to really be successful.
Mm-hmm. And I already know that you're starting to attract your tribe. So big was one small, and in order for those people such as Tony Robbins and these other people that you mentioned, not taking anything away from them, because some of them are my mentors as well, but at the same time, always remember everything big was one small, and that you have a story too to share to the world, even at the state that you're in. And it's really so inspiring, because, you know, a lot of people may be looking at you, whether it's on social media or friends, or people or your customers, wanting to do the same things that you're doing, but not really sure of how to do it. Yes. Or there's something that's a block within their life that's preventing them, whether that's fear, whether that's doubt, whether that's challenges. So, which lead me into the next question for you, like, you know, could you pinpoint on one or two significant failure or challenges that you've had to face in, you know, creating Atija Style, even though you had another business before, but fully transitioning into this one? And also, because you're defined as your purpose, the fashion world, the fashion industry, retail. Have there been any blocks or challenges that you've faced so far?
I'm about to hit my second month, okay? Mm-hmm. So that's nothing. I'm a newbie. Yeah. I'm nowhere yet, okay? And let me tell you, it's a lot. Like, I literally eat, breathe, and sleep this right now. I'm obsessed with it. And time is a big issue, because there's so much you're going to want to do, and it's going to seem like it's not enough time. But you have to be able to schedule yourself in a certain way where you can get a large amount of stuff done. The main thing I would say is money. It's going to always come back to money.
Right.
Financial-wise, I personally said I do not want to take out a loan. When I start, I really want to work from the ground up. Mm-hmm. I want to use my own funding and get me there. I don't want to develop a large debt. Of course, going forward, when I see it starts to grow some attraction and as money starts to flow in, I'll feel more comfortable taking out a loan so I can scale up. But money is going to be the biggest problem, because everything takes money. I just did an order the other day, and I tried to say, let me do 2-day shipping because I needed outfits like ASAP for the holidays. And I selected 2-day not knowing. I'm like, okay, maybe it's going to be $40 or something, right? When they billed me, because they billed you at the end, it was $144.
Yeah.
$144 could have gotten me another outfit, okay? So it's all about money, but I had to just say, it's money. It's going to come back. That's how it is. So money's going to be one of the biggest issue you face trying to start a business. Honestly, if you have friends or family who are willing to help you, and that's the best scenario. If you don't have it, you're just going to have to really grind hard. And right now, I'm paying my bills. I'm paying my personal bills. And then whatever's left over, that's put into my business. That's all it is. I'm not going out. I'm not eating out. I'm not doing anything extra. It's bills or business bills. That's all it is. So you have to really
back up. That's true. And let's talk about that a little bit, because that's real and that's genuine, because oftentimes the 9-to-5 is the investor for the business.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't talk about that. And so separate from the investment from the 9-to-5, paying all your other business, investing back in the business, if you don't choose to take out a personal loan, and even if you take out a personal loan, you still have to repay that, right?
Yeah.
So what about time sacrifice? We spoke about money. We spoke about time sacrifice. We also spoke about, budgeting will be come into the money, because not eating out, you know, making sacrifice for the long-term goal to see your business grow and eventually for it to, you know, take over your full-time job, or replace, I should say, your full-time job. And so how have you so far, like some of the challenges that you're going through and experience with building this business, like what keeps you motivated? What keeps you going? You know, is there anything that you can share with someone who's looking to start or probably have start, but how do you continue on that journey?
Honestly, I continue, and what keeps me going is that I'm tired. I'm tired of living the same life. I'm tired of stressing over the same thing. And you know what? Like I said, I had an accident, right? And after I had an accident, I was crying for so long, because it's like stuff that you work for, my car, all that stuff is with me. And just like that, it's gone. And I had to really just take the time and like talk to God. I started focusing on different things. I dive deep into motivational videos. I was stalking YouTube so hard. I was like, let me just try something else. And I just started listening to the great speakers. And I said, okay, they said to study the people that, you know, that you want to be like someday. You want to achieve what they achieve. And I started studying them very, very hard. And I said, you know what? I have to start taking accountability. Mm-hmm. You know, life is hard. But sometimes I realized that I actually made my life harder with certain decisions that I made. Like, I let fear take over my life. I don't want to be in the same position I was last year. So I decided, okay, I want 2020 to be a different year. So I have to start 2019, because you can't go into the new year just starting. You have to start out the year before, test, fail. So when you get to the year that you want to accomplish your goals, it's not even an easier road, but you see success coming. Mm-hmm. So, you know, like, that's just the biggest thing. I don't want to live a mediocre life. It's not for me. I'm going to be honest. Some people might not like hearing that, but I think you know what you want out of life. And I feel like since I was a kid, I had a drive and I didn't understand it. You know, I have a hustler mentality. I am very passionate about things. So I feel like I have that passion for a reason. My mom, I don't want to see my mom struggle anymore. Mm-hmm. Somebody has to change something in my family, and it might just have to be me, or just say it's going to be me.
Right. I love it. And so that was what my mentor, Adam Marquette, would say, your pivotal moment. Your why, really, your mom, but then something significant and traumatic as the accident really hit home for you. And so it sort of lets you look at everything. It's kind of like your life flashed in front of you, and you're like, Tatiana, it's time to stop wasting time. And so I'm laughing because, you know, sometimes, not that you wanted that to happen to you, but maybe it needed to happen for you to sort of wake up. And that's so I'm happy. and grateful that you're on your path and you're on your journey and you're really doing it and you're killing it. I've been watching you, and I have to say, you know, on the record that I'm very proud, and that you're leading with being bold, pursuing your passion, and not being fearless about it. Because if you don't go after what you want for your life and for your family's life, then, you know, you'll be, when you get older, you'll be like, oh my gosh, what did I do with my life? And you'll have a lot of regret.
Yeah.
And so I'm happy that you have a strong why, not only for yourself, but for your family. So that will propel you on days when it gets hard, when it gets challenging.
Yeah.
And I love that you have strategies as well, which would have led me into my other question. But you did say that, you know, you dived deeply into listening to motivational video as a strategy that keeps you motivated or keep you in action, in flow. Are there any other maybe rituals or routines that has helped support you on this journey?
Yeah. Okay. Like I said, motivational speaking, and you know, I have to be clear about it, because I've been listening to motivational videos for years. Mm-hmm. It surprises me. For years I've been listening, but I wasn't really listening.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't really listening, because you listen to stuff and you don't apply it, you know? Mm-hmm. And I literally cut TV off. I don't really watch TV. If I watch TV, I schedule TV in my time. Mm-hmm. That's the funny part about it. So I started listening to motivational videos, and in every morning they said, oh, if you wake up around 3 to 4 o'clock in the morning, you know, whatever time you have to go to work, but choose 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock to wake up every day. Mm-hmm. You kind of program yourself and your body to wake up around that time, get stuff done, and also get yourself mentally prepared to make sure you have a good and productive day. So I started practicing it. I put my alarm for 4 o'clock in the morning every time until I just started getting up at 4 a.m. So it's like I started from the small stuff to the large stuff. So I started my morning listening to motivational video. I drive to work and listen to the motivational video. So by the time I get to work, it's like kind of embedded in me, stuck in my mind. So that's one thing I did. And that kind of built me up to kind of keeping a schedule where, you know, I'm going to accomplish stuff in the morning. So the first thing after that, I just started doing a lot of research. I researched a lot of stuff. I researched getting my business license. I looked into a lot of stuff. And you know, you said it earlier, a lot of people might not have the information. And I swear, information is what we're lacking in life. It's not that we can't do it. It's just we don't have the information. The amount of stuff I've learned since then, it's like unbelievable. So mm-hmm. I just feel people have to read. People tell you to read all the time, and it's not a joke. You really have to read and focus on things that's going to feed your mind. I didn't go out. I stopped going out. I didn't go out. I just cut that out, period. I don't go anywhere. I had to really become obsessed with saying, you know, I'm going to start the business. Because you know why? It's different for people who work a 9-to-5 job. When you work a 9-to-5 job and you're trying to start your business, you have to be the person that's doing everything.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you have the money to pay someone to go do your logo, to go apply for your business license, you're going to do everything yourself. And you're going to see how much time you need. You hear me saying you have 24 hours in a day? Oprah has 24 hours in a day. That's all you have as well. And you're going to see how that 24 hours goes so fast. But the more you can accomplish stuff in a day, the more repetitive it's going to be, and the more you're going to keep, it's going to become a natural thing for you. So
right.
If I could say anything, you know, you lack information. Anyone that's listening, you lack information. You need to go find the information.
Mm-hmm.
It's out there.
But the funny thing about this is that a lot of people don't want to invest time and energy in the thing. So if one of the objection is money, and money is a problem, the information is there. I mean, Google is like the dictionary of the world right now. Everything is on Google. Everything is on YouTube. It's a matter of, do you want to spend the time and the effort to do the research, or do you want to pay somebody to sort of accelerate that learning process faster? So you choose. If money is a problem, then you have to invest that time and the energy, which you did, Tatiana, and you made the sacrifices in order to start up your business, to research certain things that you need for the business. And, you know, it's a continuous thing. And so growth and learning is hand in hand. And, you know, especially as a solopreneur or solo entrepreneur, I also can relate where, you know, it's a lot of time, it's a lot of sacrifice, but the reward is so greater when you see, you visualize, you have an idea, you visualize it, and you see it come into like the material world. It's really fulfilling, and it confirm your purpose in this world.
Exactly. You know, into that. That's like really what it is. You know, it's not about the sales, because I promise you guys, like, I'm not making any money, okay?
You will start making
money. I will. My first month, I had 3 sales, okay? Yes. That was all my friends. And the next thing I would say, like, my friends, they have been so good to me. Yeah. That's one thing I can say. My friends, they're rooting for me. They're putting so much life into me. And I am so thankful for it, because sometimes I'm just like, oh, wow, I did all this and that's what I got from it. But my friends have been so great. I did 3 sales in November, 3 sales December. And I am happy with those 3 sales.
Of course.
Not make a sale at all.
Exactly.
But I'm getting the attraction. I know eventually it takes time. It's like you're dating. You're dating the market. They have to get to know you before they trust you. And then you're going to start, you know, buying. That's really how it is. But it's hard. It's hard. But honestly, after everything I learned and I applied, I did my logo myself. I did my business license myself. I did my seller's permit myself. I do my website. I did my website from scratch myself. I learned how to do the Instagram IGTV. I just did my YouTube banner. It's like, basically, after learning all those stuff, I can eventually say, if I go hire someone eventually when I'm out there, they can play with me. They can play
with me. Because you know how to work your business.
Exactly. You can't play with me, or you can't hold me at hostage because you think I need you for this, you know? I can take it and run my show. So I think that's the most important thing. The fact that you can build yourself from ground up, it's going to be worth a lot in the end.
Yeah, definitely. And so the message for the audience really is that getting down and dirty, because if you want to build something, it's always great that you know the inside out of the business. Yeah. And then when you start to grow, of course, you're going to outsource and build a team. But it's always important to know the inside and out of the building. And so for you, Tatiana, tell us a little bit more about Atija Style and the vision for your company. And because I know that your background is also fashion. So tell us what you see, or where Atija Style is going in the next couple years.
So first and foremost, I'll say, remember how I mentioned me that front, I'm not using the word failure anymore. How that first business was a lesson for me. And the biggest lesson I got from that is that when you're making your own product, time that you have, oh my gosh, your time is going to be so low, because you're making your own product. You have to sell it to the person. You got to do the website. So making it is very time consuming. So the different thing I did now is that I buy my stuff from vendors. I buy my stuff from vendors, because that's the easiest thing to do when you have a full-time job. It's the best thing, actually, you know? So I started there. However, in terms of buying from vendors, I also learned that, you know, there's manufacturers out there where you literally can just get your product and they'll create your item and they'll have it and send it to you, and just like that, you have your product. All these years, I've been thinking, I bought a sewing machine. Okay, I never used a sewing machine. I know how to use it a little bit, but I never used it because the time I just didn't have. So I was saying, you know, that's one thing that took me so long. I felt like I had to make my own clothing. I had to do all this, and I didn't have the time. You don't have to do that. It's 2019 going on 2020, you know? Like, I see myself, and I've already started, like, designing certain things that I want to make. Or also, you know, you can buy something and add a little extra to it. It doesn't always have to be you have to make your own stuff or design your own stuff. It's a way of bringing it to the public. So, for me, personally, I want to have 2 sides. Actually, I want to have a lot of sides. There's so many stuff, you know, that I plan. Like, my mindset now, I don't take any idea that comes to mind for a joke. It's not a joke. Like, I write everything down. I see Atija Styles, more so Atija, becoming like an umbrella company. Mm-hmm. I want to have clothing for women. I want to have clothing for kids. I want to have clothing for men. I want to have like accessories. Mm-hmm. I want it to be a full-on brand. That's what I'm looking for. So I want to have the side where I have the products that I buy from vendors, but I also want to have the premier side with things that I make or styles that I come up with, so I can have the best of both worlds. So in the long run, my vision for Atija Styles is just becoming a household name and a place where, when it comes to fashion, everybody can get something. I want to have something for the curvy girls. I even want to have something for the church goers, because I know, you know, church goers, they love their fashion, and nobody dresses up more than a Sunday sister, okay? Right. So that's right. Another thing. I don't want to take anything for granted. I want to try as much as I can try when it comes to this.
And I have to say, you're doing so well, and I'm so impressed about it. And I'm so impressed on your growth, because I know you have it in you. And I see you going much, much further, and the business growing. Trust me on that. Mm-hmm. And so tell us how the audience can get in contact with Atija Style if they wanted to look at your website, contact with you.
All right. So on Instagram and Facebook, it's at Atija Styles, and I spell it out. It's A as in Apple, T as in Tom, I, J as in Jack, A, Styles, fully spelled out. That's Instagram and Facebook. I just did my YouTube channel, which I'm starting tomorrow, and I'm so excited. It's Tatiana Atija. You can find me on there. And then from those social media platforms, you can find other means to meet me. Twitter. I cannot figure out Twitter to say
that. Oh, awesome. Awesome. And so if somebody wanted to consult you as a stylist to pick, outfits for them, do you offer that service?
That's the part. So it's funny that you said that, because like if you remember, if you watch my IGTV.
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
My IGTV, realized that lately I've been doing styling with myself, because you know what? It's so many people doing fashion, so many people doing clothing. So I wanted to find some way for me to stand out. And another thing, I know I can style people. Mm-hmm. I have. So I said to myself, okay, what if I take items from my store and I just show a different way to style the same outfit? Because as females, we tend to not want to wear the same stuff twice. Me, I don't really care. I spend my money. I'm going to wear myself. I don't care. Mm-hmm. But I also switch it up when I wear it. So yes, that's a part of it. Like, I want to have and that's another plan. So it's funny you're bringing that up.
So for 2020, I'll just declare it here. Tatiana Atija will be offering consulting services.
Styling services.
And you can book her on our website.
Styling services, we're going to offer that, definitely.
Yeah, awesome. And so in closing, Tatiana, is there any sort of mantra, or, you know, some people use Bible verse or statement or something, some motivational quote that sticks out to you that you sort of live by, or it has helped to support you in your journey, your personal journey, your business journey?
That's so rough, because I feel like there's so many. There's so many I've studied, so many. The one thing that really stood out, and you can't quote me on it, I think it was Earl Nightingale. If it wasn't Earl Nightingale, it was Zig Ziglar, because I've been studying people, okay? And it was basically saying that you need to use your imagination like a child and execute it like an adult.
Hmm.
So you need to think like a child, because if you think about it, when we were born, we were dreamers. When we were younger, we were dreamers and we were fearless, okay? How many ideas did you have as a child? How many ideas? When I was younger, I wanted to be a writer. I wanted to be a dancer. Those are the things I wanted to be. And it still comes back to my creative side, you know, when you think about it. However, as you get older, life takes over. You get more fearful because you got bills and all those stuff. You can't take as much chances, but you can't let go of your imagination. Everything we have on this earth started from imagination, if you think about it. And it took someone to really decide, I'm going to do it, I'm going to make it happen, and here we are. Mm-hmm. So if you have something you really want to do, dream it every single day. However, make sure you plan it, work towards it as an adult. So dream like a kid, use your imagination, and execute your dream like an adult. simple as
and
that.
And I really love it because, you know, a lot of these quotes are Bible verse, because even Albert Einstein, when you said that, I remember the quote by Albert Einstein that says, imagination is everything. It's the preview of life's coming attraction. And also that's in the Bible as well. Not in those same words, but it's like you have to imagine things and speak it into existence. And so, you know, it's very true. It's like as children, you know, we are so creative. We have so many different aspirations. And so as adults, if only we could tap into our childlike self and execute on those dreams, you know, to make them reality. So I really love that. And I think that's a great way to close, especially the year 2020, the ending of a decade. And
also, it's about to be 2020.
Yeah, 2020 vision. So visualizing.
Year doesn't even exist.
Exactly.
2020 vision is real, guys. I don't know if you don't sleep on it. I really feel like 2020, if you really put stuff, you know, you put your mind into it, this is your breakthrough year.
I was just going to say, you know, like, you should start from 2019. You had a week less. You should start from now. Write down your goals so you can take it into 2020. Don't do that resolution. That resolution does not work. So for 2021, you have to start doing what you want to do from 2020. That's how you're going to go into the new year with your mindset to achieve what you want. Simple as that.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. Any last words from you?
Those are kind of last words. But my last word to you is, guys, follow Atija Styles, please, on Instagram and Facebook. Like, I'm going to do so many things. Like, I have so many creative things that I want everyone to see. And, you know, as a Jamaican female, you know, I did a lot of research and I realized that we're not in the forefront of certain markets. I don't know why. That's why Jamaicans are creative overall. I have something that's different from Atija Styles, something that's for Caribbean people, something to really put my culture out there. So follow me because I really will need your support, because your girl is going global and she's going after her dreams, okay?
And she will. And I'm so happy and proud of her, and I co-sign everything that she just said. So check her out over at atijastyles.com, and the information will be in the show note. So thank you for coming on, Tatiana. I'm very humbled and honored to have you here. And I know that there is many different gems and strategies that, you know, anyone can use in whether their personal life or business life. And so, my friends, thanks. That's another episode of Your Purpose and Business Podcast, and I'll catch you in the next episode. Bye.
Love you. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you for listening. If you've loved this episode, let's stay in touch. Head over to RaquelWalters.com and subscribe to my email list so that I can send you updates on new episodes, exclusive motivational nuggets, and insider knowledge that's only shared when you join our community. Please don't forget to subscribe to this podcast and leave a review, as I want to know your thoughts about every episode. Follow me on Instagram at Your Purpose and Business Podcast. And remember, your life is beautiful and this is a part of your journey. So embrace it. Speak to you soon.